Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to cover another palette function, which is Enrich palette function. For this video, we'll take a short example in SAP CPI. We'll try to build a sample integration flow by using a content modifier and Enrich palette function. I'll try to show you an end-to-end demonstration how we can use these two palette functions to enrich data in a given integration scenario. Let's start by asking a question: what is Enrich function? Imagine when you go to a restaurant and if you order a pizza, you ask for toppings. When you add more toppings to pizza, the pizza will be more tastier and delicious. Similarly, we use Enrich palette function to enrich the data that is coming in from the source systems. By using Enrich function, you can enhance the data and data structure in a given message. In this demo, I have taken a sender which sends customer information to the integration flow. In the integration, I used a content modifier to set some headers and extend properties. I have used Enrich palette function to enrich the data by using a OData lookup. What it does is, it calls the OData service by passing the customer data and it gets the invoice details and fills in the whole information of invoices in the given message. In content enricher function, there are two modes. One is combine mode. The other one is enrich mode. When you use combined mode, what happens is the original message and the lookup message obtained from the external call are combined into single enhanced payload. As you can see in the picture, the messages are kept separate within the combined payload, which means you have access to both set of data independently. In the other mode, which is enrich mode, you actually merge the original and lookup messages more granularly. In this mode, you can specify exactly how the data from the lookup message should be added to the original message, such as appending new elements or attributes. In the below example, you can see how I merged the invoice details to the customer node. Without further delay, let's get into the demonstration. Okay, let's start with the demo. As you can see, I have implemented this integration flow, and if you open the SOAP channel, try to configure a SOAP adapter and enter this address. And you can keep these parameters like this, manual and request reply and user role, and put the standard user role, which is already there. And keep the other settings as it is. Okay, so connection. And now in the integration process, in the start step, there's nothing to be done here. Now in the content and modifier, so I added following parameters in the message header, which is customer ID, because I'm going to filter the data based on the customer ID, which is XPath expression, and it is the node value is customer ID and type string Java string. Just enter the values like this. And in the exchange properties, added a new parameter which is also customer ID as well, and here XPath and customer ID, and the data type is on the string here. And there is no settings in the message body. Okay, so message header and exchange properties to be set. Okay, now let's move on to the content enrich function, which is the topic here. Now in the processing, I selected the type combine. This is the algorithm I want to use here, combine algorithm. And now let's look into the OData connection configuration. So I created an OData adapter communication channel, and it is of type OData version v2. And if you go to the connection details, so this is the URL for the OData service, which is open and free. You can use it the same. And proxy type is internet, and there is no authentication. I just want to use a trail no authentication mode here. And in the processing section, so this is where you do the configuration. It defines how you make the call to OData service. And if you click on the select, so I created this OData configuration here. So I used an operation query get, and I'm just selecting entity invoices. And just selected some random fields, the customer information and order information, and some shipping information as well. And I used a filter. Basically, I'm filtering on the customer ID, which is equal to the header.CustomerID. field. Okay, so this is the header field that we configured already, so I'm just filtering on the customer ID. So you just use the wizard to create this configuration. It is out of the box, straightforward. I'm just going to cancel it because I already created this one, so let me finish this one. So maybe what I can do is I can keep this query in the description. You can use the query as it is in your practice. Okay. So it's very simple. So the OData config is straightforward here. Now I created all the steps. So sender and receiver and content modifier and content enricher. So now save it. And now let's deploy the integration flow. So deploy. Yes. Now you can see the status of the deployment will appear shortly. Now it started and deployed and started, pretty good. Now let's go to the monitoring part. So click on monitor again, integration and APIs. Now you go to the monitoring section where you monitor the integration processes. Yeah, so you can see. So basically now let's test it. So I used this SAP UI here and I used a customer ID field basically here. And as you can see, this is the endpoint of the interface that you deployed to the in the tenant. So now click on the execute button. As you can see, I got the response back and the response code is 200, which is good. 200 is a successful call. And if you click on the XML tab, as you can see here, this is the response from the integration flow. So basically what it does is, because we used combined algorithm, it created two message parts. This is message part one and message part two. In the message part one, it includes the original message. In the message part two, it includes the lookup message. As you can see, this is the lookup of all the invoices of that particular customer ID. Okay. So this is the construct that we receive as part of the enrich function using a combined algorithm. So we have message one, that is the original message. And message 2 is the lookup message that we receive from the OData service. Okay, as you can see, we have all the invoices here. So basically the requirement is we pass the customer ID to the OData service. It should return all the invoices of that customer. So that was the requirement and we got the response as expected. Okay. Now, let's go to the monitoring here again. So as you can see in the artifacts, we have the message processing, the message processed successfully, there's no error, so everything is clean. That's why we got the response. Okay. Now what I'll do is I go back to the integration process. I try to change the algorithm from the combined to the enrich. So as I explained earlier, if you use enrich, what happens is it actually merges the original message and the lookup message. As you can see here, you have to do a bit of configuration in the enrich algorithm. So you have to define the original message segments and also the lookup message segments. Okay. So let me fill the information. So if you go back to the SAP UI, let me define the path to the node from where it has to pick the key element for the original message. So if I go back here, the original message is coming under customer details. Okay. Customer details slash and customer. So basically that is a node from where I got this information. Okay, now enter the key element, which is the customer ID. Okay, let me enter the key element here. So basically this is the lookup value that we pass to the OData service or to the enrich function. Now in the lookup message, so let me look at the message here. And here we have invoices slash invoice. So I need to read the invoices in the invoice. Okay, and the key element I need to look up based on the customer ID. So if you look at the invoice data, so it is a customer ID. Okay, so this is a configuration that you need to do. So basically it is going to merge the original message and lookup message based on the configuration that you define here. So now let's save this configuration and deploy it. Then we'll try to run the scenario and see what happens. Okay, so let's save it first and deploy the integration flow. So once it is successfully deployed and started, we can execute the scenario. Let's wait for it. Yeah, it's now deployed and started. Okay. Let's go back to the SAP UI. And now I'm going to click play or send. You see, I received the message 200 status back, which is successful execution. And if you go to the XML tag here, let's have a quick look here. You see here, so we have the root node, the customer node. Under that, basically it combined the input message, the original message customer ID, and also the invoices. So it actually merged the original message and the lookup message. So this is the difference between the combine algorithm and the enrich algorithm. Okay, so that's it about the enrich function. It's very popular and it's very well used palette function, one of the important palette function that you need to remember. Remember, combine works separately and enrich works separately. It's pretty simple. Hope you understand the difference between the enrich and combine here. So that's it for the demo. And if you like the video, always consider giving a like, share the video and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.